Memory allocation is of two types, static memory allocation and dynamic memory allocation. Allocating memory during compile time is called static memory allocation. In static memory allocation, once memory size allotted cannot be changed. We cannot even increase or decrease the memory size. Allocating memory during runtime is called dynamic memory allocation. And in dynamic memory allocation, memory size can be increased or decreased. Dynamically allocated memory is allotted in heap, and non-static and local variables get memory allotted on stack. Dynamically allocated memory is to allocate memory of variable size, which is not possible with compile time memory allocation, that is static. And the major application area is data structures, linked lists, trees, stacks, queues, graphs, etc. Now, what do you mean by variable length array? Now, if you declare a statement like, you just imagine a two-dimensional array of size 3, 3, three rows, three columns, we can have variable length arrays. First row with one column, second row with two columns, and third row with four columns is also possible. The normal declarations like int a semicolon, char str, in these type of declarations, memory is automatically allocated and deallocated. Whereas in dynamically allocated memory, like what we do in C++ with the help of new operator, we need to deallocate memory when no longer is needed. Otherwise, it causes memory leak. In C, we use malloc, calloc, and realloc functions and free to free dynamically allocated memory. Whereas in C++, we use new and delete. We use the term operators, new operator and delete operator, for allocating and freeing the memory. We don't use the term delete in Java. Automatic garbage collection is available in Java. We use new, but we don't have delete in Java. The basic syntax of new operator is pointer variable is equal to new and data type. A data type could be any built-in data type, including array, or any user-defined data type, including structures and classes. The new operator initializes the memory and returns address of the newly allocated and initialized memory to the pointer variable. If sufficient memory is available, look at the first example. Int star p is equal to null and p is equal to new int. Look at the comments. Pointer initialized with null and then request memory for the variable. We can combine the declaration and assignment. We can put it in one statement like int star p is equal to new int. We can also initialize the memory using new operator. Look at the example. Yeah, basic syntax is pointer variable is equal to new data type within brackets. Whatever the value you want to initialize with, put the value based on the data type. So int star p is equal to new int within brackets 25. Even you can allocate a block of memory, array. Look at the syntax. Pointer variable is equal to new data type within brackets, square brackets. We use square brackets for array size. It specifies the number of elements in an array. Int star p is equal to new int of 10. Dynamically allocates memory for 10 integers of type int and returns pointer to the first element of the sequence. P of 0 refers to first element, P of 1 refers to second element, and so on. As I explained already, in normal way of declaration, either an ordinary variable or an array, allocating a block of memory using new, the basic difference is, if you do it with new, that is dynamically allocated arrays, you need to deallocate by yourself. What if there is no enough memory? If enough memory is not available in the heap to allocate, the new request indicates a failure by throwing an exception. Exception is nothing but an error. We can use no throw with new operator, in which case it returns a null pointer. It won't give you an error. Look at the example clearly. At the time of allocating, we used no throw. If not P, memory allocation fail. It won't give you an error, but it will give you a message. We'll be discussing what exactly is an exception and what are the types of exceptions in the chapter Exception Handling in C++. So to deallocate a dynamically allotted memory, we use delete operator. The basic syntax is delete pointer variable semicolon. To free the dynamically allocated array pointed by pointer variable, we use the syntax delete empty square brackets, pointer variable, and semicolon. Just practice this program, a demonstration program, but new. Check it out how many pointer variables are there. PTR1, PTR2, and PTR3. And try to observe the difference and declaring PTR1, PTR2, and PTR3. PTR1 is declared and assigned with null, and PTR2 is of data type float with a value 223.324, and PTR3 is of array. What is the array size here? 28. So go through the program clearly, no confusion. PTR1 is equal to 28, it is an assigned pointer variable. 1 is assigned with 28 as we declared PTR1 and is of null there. Now look at the for loop. I is equal to 10, I less than 15, and I plus plus. What happens when I is 10? PTR3 of I is equal to I plus 1. We'll see the output. Value of pointer variable 1 is 28. we declared it and initialized null, and later we assigned 28. Pointer to PTR2, at the time of declaration itself, it is initialized with 223.324, and PTR3 is of array, and we use for loop for assigning few values. No confusion regarding 10, 15. No, the basic array size there is 28. We can use all the elements. No confusion regarding all these things. The same program, we just added few statements. Delete PTR1, delete PTR2, and look at delete PTR3. PTR3 is array. So look at the square brackets.